I am so excited. I think you're going to love this video today. I like to do meal prep a little bit differently, and that's why I feel like hopefully you'll find this video helpful. I like to prep out certain types of food that I can create into different recipes, and I wanted to make this video simple too. Like, I don't want you to think that I like always go all out for breakfast, like 100%. Every single meal is like this deep, complex, super interesting. I'm a chef, which I like to consider myself a chef. But let's be real, not everybody has time for that. I don't have time for that. So I wanted these to be really real raw recipes that actually are delicious.
Would it be too punny to say that this granola recipe will make you go nuts? Probably, but it's my favorite recipe of all time because it's easy to prep and easy to store, and not to mention, it's delicious. So you wanna take 1.5 cups of your choice of nuts, and I use cashews, almonds, and walnuts, and then measure out 1/4 cup of maple syrup along with 1 cup of shredded coconut and 1/2 cup of almond meal. That's really gonna give it that cluster and good crunch. Then I'm gonna measure out 1/2 teaspoon of pink Himalayan salt to really bring the flavors alive. And then you want to add in your roughly chopped up nuts into that mixture. And I like to use my hands because I feel like I can just really incorporate everything together. Now this is where you get to be the chef and the flavor director for this granola. I'm adding a sprinkle of cinnamon, but you could do cacao. I've even added vanilla powder over the top of it before. You can really customize this and make it taste however you want. It's delicious no matter how you flavor it. All you have to do is make sure that you bake it correctly. So spread it out onto a sheet of parchment paper over a sheet pan, and then you want to pop it into the oven at 325 degrees. My oven takes exactly 8 minutes, and then I flip it over, give it a good toss, and then another 5 minutes in the oven does the trick for me. So really watch it. You will see when it gets to be that goldeny brown color. Now, there are so many different ways to enjoy this granola. You can eat it plain just as it is, just take it to go, kind of like a dry cereal, or my personal favorite way to eat it is like cereal with homemade almond milk and topped with fruit. It's so flavorful and delicious. Another way you can eat it is like parfait style. I ran out of coconut yogurt, but layer up your yogurt and your fruit. Make sure that the fruit is separating the granola and the yogurt so it doesn't get soggy. Doesn't this look like a cereal commercial? It really does, like it definitely does. This stores beautifully in an airtight container. You can store it in the fridge for literally weeks. You will be able to enjoy this for a really long time, but you're probably gonna eat it super quickly, so I wouldn't even worry about that. Moving right along into the next recipe, this is coconut oatmeal. Now, this is amazing because it's vegetable-based. We're gonna use a roasted butternut squash. So you wanna roast it for about 40 minutes at 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Measure out 2 cups of the roasted squash, along with just under 1 cup of shredded coconut. I'm using the finely shredded coconut just for the texture here. And then I like to use canned coconut milk because I find it to be a lot more creamy. We're gonna use about 1 cup of that, and as you can see, I measured out just a little bit too much, but it's okay, and Meester always wants some of my food. Then you wanna pop that onto the stovetop and mix it up until it's kind of bubbly like oatmeal. I sprinkled in a little bit of cinnamon just to give it a little bit more flavor, and added in just a splash of maple syrup and a tiny pinch of sea salt. Mixed it all up, and you wanna just serve it just like oatmeal. This stores amazingly in the freezer if you want to just freeze it in little tiny glass mason jars. You just want to make sure that you obviously thaw it overnight so that you can enjoy it in the morning. I surprisingly loved adding peanut butter onto this. It was so good. And you can always double the recipe to really prep out a lot. So let's just recap how incredible this meal prepped breakfast is. It's full of fiber from the squash. Adding in the coconut shreds makes it full of healthy fats, and then topping it with fruit and even peanut butter or almond butter, more healthy fats, just so good for your brain. And this is literally amazing for energy, and you can freeze it. So it's great for meal prep. Not to mention that it's absolutely delicious. So the next recipe, as you can already see, I've been making my chia seed pudding here. I recently learned that you can actually freeze chia seed pudding and it thaws beautifully. So this is what makes it ideal for meal prep. And you can freeze it in tiny little glass jars, as you can see that I'm making mine in this little one. And all you have to do is measure out 2 tablespoons of your chia seeds and just under a cup of whatever milk you prefer. I'm using oat milk actually for this recipe, just to switch things up. And you can honestly eat it like that, or you can add in a tiny little bit of vanilla and a splash of maple syrup, and that's it. You just let it set up in the fridge for a while, and you can make so many batches of these. Freeze them, thaw them the night before, top it with the granola that I showed you guys earlier, or even add in some chopped fruit. You could, again, make it like a parfait, add in some coconut yogurt or whatever yogurt that you prefer on top. In other words, the sky is the limit with this chia seed pudding, and it's an incredible meal prepped breakfast. Now, I wanted this video to be something that you could easily take away from and immediately apply it into your life. And that meant just me being honest with what I actually do for meal prep when it comes to breakfast. And that is simply just chopping and roasting sweet potatoes. You could do this with so many different veggies. You could do it with zucchini, with onion, whatever your taste buds prefer. But I find that it seems like, at least for me in my life, one of the biggest hurdles in healthy eating is the time that it takes, or consumes, if you will, in our lives to prep out healthy food. But the reality is, this little veggie chopper has made it so much easier for me, because I perfectly can evenly chop up veggies, roast them super quickly for 20 to 25 minutes at 400 degrees, and you can freeze them and use them just like you would any other frozen vegetable that you pick up at the store. I like to eat it with just like a poached egg. You could use your veggies in a scramble. I mean, this is a really tangible idea that you can take away from this video and apply immediately. It's not some big, crazy, hard, difficult recipe, but it's just a simple tip that you can take away and apply right away.
I really hope you enjoyed those recipes watching that, but more than anything, I hope you go out and make those recipes and you enjoy even more, because words can never express how delicious the food that I showed you in this video is. I didn't finish the sentence. I hope that you can see from this video too that it can be really simple. I just think it's easier to like eat and live this way if I simply prep sweet potatoes. Like, it literally makes my life easier. I personally used to really struggle with binge eating, and one of the reasons that I did is because I obsessed about food so much, because I thought that if I could control like what I ate, and I know I say this all the time, you guys, but like, I really like want to help you, and I feel like so many people still struggle. If you're watching this video and you just feel trapped and you just feel stuck and you feel like no matter how hard you try to eat healthy, you just can't seem to maintain it. You just can't seem to enjoy it. You can't seem to wake up in the morning without obsessing about what you're going to eat and then feeling bad, or looking into the future and thinking, well, how am I going to eat? And you know, response to what I ate for breakfast and what I just ate set the whole tone for my day, and now my whole day is ruined. And I used to have those thoughts, and I used to live in that kind of a way. And I know that maybe you're watching this video and you're feeling the same way. I think that we can become so consumed with what's on our plate that we forget what's going on in our minds. And the real question for am I eating healthy is, am I eating whatever is on my plate in a healthy way? Am I not making myself feel shameful or guilty? I just really want you to leave this video feeling like no matter what you eat for breakfast, no matter what you eat throughout the day, no matter what you do that, you know, makes you live a healthy lifestyle, that you are like coming from a place that is healthy. It's just, it's so twisted to me, like, that we could think that, you know, I'm just gonna eat a healthy green salad smoothie for breakfast, and you could actually be doing it from one of the most unhealthy mental places ever. And that literally breaks my heart, because I don't want you to live like that. I don't want you to live, you know, trapped inside of a cage that you literally can get out of in an instant. You know, you don't have to live that way, even starting now. I always used to think it was like this future freedom that I was gonna have. And I remember the day that I stopped dieting, and I literally drove to the Coffee Bean and Tea Leaf and I got myself a coconut pineapple muffin. I'll never forget that for the rest of my life. And that changed everything for me. Did I look different physically? Absolutely not. That's physiologically impossible. But it doesn't matter because I made the decision in my mind, I'm no longer going to be enslaved to myself. Like, I'm gonna actually walk in truth even if my mind hasn't followed yet. Does that make sense? Like, it's an action. Like, it's literally like a choice that we're gonna make. So like, maybe the healthiest thing that you ever could do is like, eat a muffin or eat a donut or whatever, because maybe that's gonna be actually healthier for your mind. And I think there's so many things I could talk about, because I actually got a question on one of my last videos, like, Cambria, I love this, like, I love freedom and like walking in freedom, and but like, how do I also do that in a disciplined way? And I think for me, my body followed the way that I led myself. And what I mean by that, if you got confused by that, because it's not very specific, is that like, I ate that muffin, and then I also will never forget how sluggish I felt afterwards, and it made my stomach hurt. At that time, I didn't really know I was allergic to gluten. So anyway, like, your body will tell you, you know what I mean? Like, I don't really feel good. I kind of, if you're waking up in the morning and you're eating your breakfast and you're like, man, I feel really tired and like, I feel sluggish and I just don't feel well, my stomach kind of hurts, maybe it's time to, you know, assess what you are eating, because you want to actually feel good. Like, who doesn't want to wake up in the morning and eat a breakfast that makes them feel good and energized? Like, I'm pretty sure that's what we all want, but we also want to be satisfied and we want to eat yummy food, and but we don't, deep down, we don't want to overindulge. That's why we have those questions of like, how do I be disciplined? We want to be disciplined, we want to be healthy, but we don't want to be unhealthy. And what I mean by that is, we don't want to become enslaved to our restrictive obsessiveness. And that's where freedom comes in, where it's like actual real freedom of like, hey, I can eat a donut and I can eat a salad for breakfast, and I am just so free in my mind that no matter what I do, it's coming from a place of honestly like inner health. And I love that Jesus said, you know, don't worry about your food, your clothing, what you're gonna put on your body. Like, life is more than food. Like, that's one of my favorite things that Jesus said of all time. Like, life is more than food. And for so long, everything for me revolved around food, because everything revolved around perfecting my image. And it was the most destructive thing that I ever did, because it was so much more than food. It was so much more than what was on my plate. It was literally what was going on in my spirit and in my soul of this horrible bondage to something that was never gonna make me happy. Like, that's why I talk about this so much, is because I think we need to constantly be reminded of the truth that a number on the scale is never going to make you happy and satisfied. Like, it just won't. And we all know that, and yet we go after and we chase it anyways. And I just want this video, I really pray that this video is like a breath of fresh air and a good reminder that it doesn't matter necessarily exactly what you eat. Everyone is so different. Everybody's bodies are so different. Your value is never changing depending on what you eat. If you're waking up in the morning and you are feeling guilty and bad about what you ate or what you didn't eat or when you should eat or how much you should eat, or if those thoughts are even like consuming your mind, I just want you to know that like, literally right now in this moment, you can be free from that. Like, you can literally choose to say, I'm no longer going to obsess. I'm no longer gonna make that the highest thing on my priority list. I'm gonna eat healthy and I'm gonna live in a healthy way because I'm free to do that. Not, I'm in bondage to myself, I must do this. I hope you can wake up in the morning and your day is good and has nothing to do with what's on your plate and like what you eat. And I just used to be dictated by that. And so I hope that that has nothing to do with it now. And I hope it plays a small part in making you feel good and how you live your day and your life. Cause I love food, I love to cook. I'm obsessed with, and see, when I say obsessed, I mean in like the best sort of way. I am obsessed with cooking and just like, I love to bake, I love to cook, I love recipes, that's just who I am. I've loved that since I was a little girl in fourth grade, coming home to watch the Food Network long before I even knew what a diet was or dieting was or healthy living was. I was literally like watching Rachel Ray and Gianna and Duff and Bobby Flay and you name it, I was watching all of them, and because I love it and it's just something that I enjoy. And so I hope that you can enjoy living a way that is freeing. And I hope that it's done in a healthy mindset of like, I'm free. Please let me know in the comments if you have any questions, anything that I can address in my next video about eating and eating in a way that is like honestly honoring to your body, that makes you feel good. If you are struggling, if you have questions, like I really wanna help you. You can change your life before January 1st. You don't have to wait until Monday, and you don't have to wait until tonight, tomorrow morning. You don't have to wait any longer. Like, stop waiting. Like, we only have right now, we only have this moment. Like, just give yourself grace. Remember the words of Jesus of like, don't worry about, life is more than food. You know, life is more than our bodies, what we're gonna put on. Like, don't let your adornment be merely outward. You know, let's like get our eyes off of the mirror and like actually look at what's internally going on in our souls, you know? And we're just gonna find so much joy there. There is so much joy when you lay down the things that you were once gripping so tightly, because you're gonna find that you can actually enjoy those things so much more. I hope you can leave this video like thinking about like not what's on my plate, but like what's going on in my heart, you know? So that's just what I wanna say. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to click the post notifications button to get notified whenever I upload a video. So let me know if you wanna see that. And with all that being said, click thumbs up, turn on post notifications, follow me on Instagram so we can hang out and be friends, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.